is.
That's not a is symbol. In a sentence, if you say something is, then you could use an equal sign to kind of represent that relationship. But that is an equals symbol. Okay, saying is a way of saying things are equal. This is that. But it is an equal sign, an equality sign. So what are these symbols called?
Plus.
Okay, that's what they mean. What they've got a name though. That one's an equality sign. So you've maybe never heard this word before?
A differential sign.
No. Differential is a calculus word.
Okay.
It doesn't mean that, but I mean it's a good attempt. Well, this one means that both sides are what?
Equal.
Equal. Same, exactly the same. Does this mean that? Does this mean that both sides are equal?
No.
In fact, it means about the opposite. Right? It means that, right, literally that both sides are not equal. They're unequal. These are called inequality signs. Right? You know, when you put this guy at the front of a word, it usually means not, right? So, inequality. Okay? And you hear this applied to human beings too, right? Inequality. Because we treat people in a way that we ought not to, we treat them without equality. But with numbers don't care if they're not equal or if they are equal. So this one, as in the example I'm putting here, x is less than 6. Right? X is not equal to 6. The only way that x cannot be equal to 6 is x is bigger than 6 or x is smaller than 6. And they're saying x is less than 6. Right? So we apply that to all of these. Can we say what this one says?
Y is greater than -3.
Y is. What does that mean?
It's a bigger number.
Okay. Really, y is greater than -3. How could you visualize that? How could you show me that y is greater than -3? Johnny?
On a number line.
Great, on a number line, yeah. So we could draw a little number line here. Number one, what we think. There's a 0 there. -3, let's put it right there. And so you show me that y is greater than -3 how?
Just put y to the right of -3.
It's like put one right there?
Sure.
Okay. Is that all though? Are those the only possibilities?
You would put it like, I remember there was like certain kinds of circles where you'd have like a filled in circle means something and an open circle means something, that you would like put it on like a filled in circle on 3 and you would put it to the right.
Or something
arrow.
Like that.
Arrow to the right.
Well, let's just talk about this point right here. Let's say this point is at, let's call it 3.5. Is 3.5 a number that y could be?
Yes.
Why? How come?
It's
-3. That's all I wanted you to. Yeah, that's all I want to be true about y. That it's greater than -3. Could it be 4?
Yes.
Could it be 3?
Yes.
Could it be 0?
Yes.
Could it be -1?
Yes.
-0.5.
Yes.
Yeah, all of these numbers, right? So how do I show all of these numbers without sitting here and boring you with point and point and point, Johnny?
Oh, you put a open circle around -3, and then you draw a line with the number line to the right.
Okay. What will I get if I just keep drawing all these points forever and ever?
A line.
Yeah, I will get a line, right? So that's what Johnny's talking about there with that line. I don't have time to draw all of these points individually, so I just kind of scribble it in. And all those scribbles represent all those points, right? And then I put a little arrow to represent. Well, I also don't have time to go on for all eternity in the right direction. So that's, you know, just keep going that way. You'll keep finding numbers that work, that are greater than -3. And then we get to -3. Well, can we go to -2.5? Would that be bigger than -3?
Yeah.
-2.75?
Yeah.
-2.9?
Yep.
2.99999999?
Yeah.
but not negative 3.
No.
Why not negative 3?
Because then it would be equal to.
Yeah, it's the negative 3 is not greater than negative 3. Negative 3 is equal to negative 3. So when we get to negative 3, we don't ever actually want to get to negative 3. We want to stop just short of negative 3. And so we show that with, as Johnny said, the open circle. A closed circle, as we just drew many, many, many of them, means that y is that thing. Y is 3.5? Put a closed circle there. Y is 2? Put a closed circle there. Y is really close to negative 3, but not actually ever equal to negative 3? Open circle. Okay. So that's how we can show on another line that y is strictly greater than negative 3. So that brings us to this guy here. Does anybody know what this one is saying?
M is greater than or equal to 4.
Good. M is greater than. Or greater than or equal to 4. Great. So if I were to show that on a number line, and I put, say, 0 is there, 1, 2, 3, 4, there's 4. Where is m allowed to be? Where are the numbers on the number line that m can be?
It could be on
4. Beyond 4. Because it can be equal to 4. If I put a 4 there, will it be true? Yeah, 4 is equal to 4, and so it meets this criteria. Where else can it be? Sean?
Everywhere else, every other point to the right.
Every other point to the right. So this point, this point, this point, this point, this point, this point, every point in between. And just any point to the right, as Sean said. Any point that's to the right will work for M.
And that's a closed circle?
It's a closed circle. Why is it a closed circle?
Because it can be on the 4 too.
Because it can be on the 4 too. If it's on the 4, that's okay because this little guy right there, equal to. M is greater than or it's equal to 4. It can be either or. So pick 17. That works. 17 is bigger than 4. Pick 4. That works because 4 is equal to 4. Pick 3. That doesn't work because 3 is not greater than 4. It's also not equal to 4. It's not either one of those things. Okay. Then what is this one saying? R is less than or equal to. We're all getting it, right? I'm going to show you, just for reference, where 0 is, there's negative 1. At negative 1, I'm going to put some kind of a dot. What kind of a dot am I going to put in? Yeah, closed point, a filled in point. And I'm also going to show you all the points that are where?
To the left.
To the left of negative. Kind of weird, numbers being like negative 2, right? Is negative 2 less than negative 1 or bigger than negative 1? Yeah, 2 sounds bigger than 1, but then we call negative 2 smaller than negative 1 because it's more to the left on the number line. Something to keep in mind. Let's look at some other ways that we could say this stuff as well. How about, these are typically, yeah, we're going to say x is less than 6, y is greater than negative 3. But we could say this a little bit differently. We could say that m is, you tell me, either at least or at most. Which is it, at least or at most? Alex?
At least.
At least. Why do you say at least?
Because that's the minimum it can be, at least.
At the very least it has to be 4, right? The least that it can be, Right, so we're gonna take out this. It has to be at least 4, the least, the smallest, the minimum that it can be is 4, and it could be anything bigger than that, so it has to be at least. Okay, you guys have heard that before, right? That phraseology, at least. You have to be at least this tall, you have to be at least this old. You have to weigh at least this much. Have to have at least this much money, whatever. At least. Okay? So how could we say this to one then? R is what?
At most.
At most. At most. The most, the biggest, the largest, the furthest to the right that R could ever be is -1. Goes past that, well, the very the worst thing that could happen, I guess, is that this inequality is not true. Okay, well, you guys are pretty familiar with inequalities, it seems like to me. Is that true?
Yeah.
You say?
Yeah.
Seen it before? Just, it's in your mind somewhere, rattling around, at least. Okay. Let's see. One more quick thing. If I tell you x is greater than 7, and I just throw this number at you, 5, okay, like x is 5, is this number 5 for x, is it a solution to this inequality?
No.
Mm-hmm. Why not? Sorry?
Because 5 is not greater than 7.
5 is not greater than 7? Okay. And another way to put that is if I take this number and I plug it in for x, then what happens? How does that thing tell me that this is not not a solution to this inequality? What is it that happens that tells me that 5 is not a solution to the inequality?
It is not greater than 7.
But if I do plug 5 in there, what does it say?
5 is greater than 7.
And that statement is?
False.
False. It's false. So when you plug something into some kind of a statement, right? This is a statement. A statement is either true or false. Okay? It's not ambiguous. Statement is true or the statement is false. Okay? And if it's not true or false, then it's just not a statement. This is definitely a statement. X is greater than 7. And when I say 5 is greater than 7, that's a statement, and that statement is false. When I make a false statement, then we don't like that. So, not a solution. Is this a solution? Is that a solution for the inequality?
Yes.
Well, more advanced on this stuff here. Let's just do two more things, huh? I'm just gonna give you over to your homework here because I think you're ready for it. Give me an example of a real life situation where you would say the words at least. Just an example of word. Everyday situation.
Like at a theme park you have to be at least this tall to rank a certain way.
Okay. So or a roller coaster or something like that. At least 42 inches tall. Maybe at least that tall. Okay. And the last thing, what about at most? Where's an example of something where you would say at most?
The road trip was at most 8 hours.
Okay, so just take us at most, right? This is kind of an estimate you're giving somebody, but it does give them an idea of what you mean. At most, the very most, it should take us 8 hours to get there. At most 8 hours. Or this could be a pretty definitive thing, like really strict labor laws. You can work at most 8 hours, right? If you go past that, then you know certain things happen. The employer pays the penalty, or you have to get overtime, or if you're a certain age, like I enjoy movies, and I know that there are really strict rules about underage, you know, minors working on set, they can work at most this many hours. They can't work past this late at night, that kind of thing. So that could be a really strict thing where at most. You just have to stop 8 hours and then, you know, start again the next day or something like that. So it's good. At least, at most, I think you get the terminology. I think what we could do today is have a pretty easy day, I think. If you have any questions, absolutely ask me those questions. But I think you guys are ready. This first installment of inequalities, big deal.
Some of us didn't finish our tests.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you could work on those too.